Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunkhe and welcome to the Web Application Penetration Testing and Secure Coding. This is video number 7 and in this video, we will set up our vulnerable application lab. So let's get started. First, we need to download Ubuntu. For that, go to the www.ubuntu.com. After that, click on desktop. Then click on download Ubuntu. Then download the version which is available. I'll click on download. After that, it will start downloading. Download the file. As we have seen earlier, for this course, we are going to use VirtualBox. After starting the VirtualBox, click on New. Then give a name here. I'm going to give Vulnerable Applications. Select the type as Linux and version as Ubuntu 64-bit. Then click on Continue. Let's give 1 GB RAM. After that, click on Continue. Then click on Create a new virtual hard disk now. Create. Select Continue. Continue. We will give 10 GB for this vulnerable applications. Click on create. Right. Select that vulnerable applications machine. Click on settings. Then click on storage. After that, click here. Then click on choose disk. Select the files which we downloaded from the Ubuntu website and then click on open. After that, click on OK. Now click on start. Now we'll click on install Ubuntu. After that, click on continue. Then erase disk and install Ubuntu. Click on install now. Continue. Then click on continue. Then just scroll here. Continue. After that, let's give a name. Let's give it a name as the vulnerable applications. Okay, give a password, right? After that, click on continue. Now it will take some time to finish the installation. I'll just fast forward this process. Okay, now it is saying installation is complete. You need to restart the computer. Click on restart now. Click on enter. Enter the password. Okay, so as we can see, Ubuntu got installed. Now to run the vulnerable applications, we need to install Apache, PHP, MySQL, etc. So instead of downloading and configuring each item separately, what we will do, we will download the XAMPP. It contains all the things which we'll need, such as Apache, MariaDB, PHP, etc. To download the XAMPP, go to the apachefriends.org. After that, download XAMPP for Linux and then save file. Okay, so I have downloaded the XAMPP installer. Now click here, type terminal. Let's go to downloads directory. For that, click on CD downloads. Okay, we have the installer. Now let's give executable permission to this file. For that, type chmod 755, then type x, and to autocomplete, just press on tab, then enter. Okay, let's check the permissions. Okay, this file got the executable permissions. So if you are having problem understanding these Linux commands, don't worry. I'll be soon making a course on Linux basics for InfoSec. Now to execute this file, we'll need a root permission. For that, type sudo dot slash file name, then press enter, then type your password. Okay, installer has started. Click on next, 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 click on next. Now it is installing. Now it got installed. After that, click on finish. Now this is the XAMPP control panel. Click on manage servers. Apache is running. To run the MySQL, select the MySQL and click on start. Okay, now MySQL is running. Now let's test. For that, click on browser. In the address bar, type localhost. Okay, we have successfully installed XAMPP in our vulnerable applications machine. Now this is going to be a directory /opt/lamp/hdocs in which we are going to host our all vulnerable applications. Now each time you boot into the Ubuntu, you need to go to the cd /opt/lamp. Now to start the XAMPP control panel, you have to type sudo /manager/linux x64.run, and by clicking on manage server, you can start the servers which will need Apache and MySQL. Now our both servers are running. To stop those from running, select the server and click on stop. Okay, those are stopped. So each time you boot into the Ubuntu, you need to go to the /opt/lamp, and after that you need to run manager -linux -x64 to start the XAMPP control panel, and after that you need to start Apache web server and MySQL database. Okay, that's what I had planned for this video. So if you're having some troubles installing Ubuntu or XAMPP, you can contact me in my email. Thank you.